Good afternoon, everybody.
Hello.
We are here in San Diego, California.
I know, we haven't been here in years.
It's been a while since we were last here. We are on a burger and taco tour here.
We are, yes. Yeah, we've done our research. We've been to these places again years ago, on some of these places.
Yeah, not all of them.
Yeah, and we're just ready to have a really good burger and some amazing tacos, aren't we?
That's right, and we are here starting off at Hodad's.
Yes.
Here at Ocean Beach.
Yes, it's an institution down here, so you definitely, if you're going to come to San Diego, you have to visit Hodad's.
Right, right. Yeah, we're going to jump in right now and get some burgers.
Yeah, I'm hungry.
Just got seated over here. Pretty loud music over here, so hopefully you can hear us. Here's the menu right here. It's pretty basic menu, all different kinds of ways you could order your burger. And they specialize in the onion rings over here, so we'll be sure to get some of those. What else do we have? Yeah, I really don't remember some of these specialty burgers.
Yeah.
That's from a long time ago. So what do we have on this side? Oh, we have our drinks, shakes, and the beer and wine here.
I believe they're also known for their shakes.
Yeah, they are. Yeah. So yeah, let me look over this menu and we'll see what we're going to get. So here we have their famous shakes. Vanilla, chocolate, or strawberry are your choices. We got the strawberry. We almost got vanilla, but it seems like we always get vanilla all the time. We got to try something different. This looks really good. The guy was in the back scooping the ice cream out of the little ice cream
holder.
Oh yeah, little bucket over there. This music is like crazy loud over here.
It's okay. We can work with it.
So let's try this out. Look at that. Oh wow. That looks really good. That is a delicious strawberry ice cream. You know, one of our favorites is like from Baskin Robbins. Mm-hmm. It tastes just as good.
Wow.
Gotta hurry up and eat some of this before it starts to melt on me. And you know, to note, Hodad's has two locations. They have one in, I believe, downtown San Diego, and this one here at Ocean Beach. But I think this is the, not the original, but the one that's been here the longest. Because I believe they started out somewhere small, close to here, and then moved into this location. The shake, delicious.
Nice and cold. I like how they serve it into the shaker. And it keeps it cold because it's metal. Oh yeah. Delicious ice cream. Very nice. It tastes like a natural strawberry, not so artificial. With it nice and thick. Oh yeah. Press that in there.
I think we made the right choice. The strawberry is really good.
It is. Yeah. This is definitely shareable. So we're off to a good start. While we're waiting for our food, it's very nice atmosphere in here. It's a bunch of old license plates from pretty much all over the country. Tons of surfboards on the wall and skate decks on the wall as well. And we're in San Diego, so you know they have also a variety of beer that you can get. And it is nice and open, and you have to wait to be seated. Our food should be coming up shortly.
Check out this burger. This is the biggest and baddest burger they have. The bacon double cheeseburger with everything on it. Look at that. Now you do have a choice between grilled onions or regular raw onions. By design, I got it raw. But look at that. This is crazy. And you know what? It's got some weight to it too. I'm going to attempt to go for this bite just by looking at this monster burger. You can't get any more American than this. This is your classic American bacon double cheeseburger. I think this is a good spot right here. That's a good spot. Here we go.
Did you really take a bite, babe? I don't see it.
Well, I opened my mouth as big as it could go, and look how much of the burger patty I got. Just a little bit. Let me try that again. Let me tell you what, This is one juicy burger. It is like literally like dripping, even though it's got the paper on the bottom of the burger. These patties are not dried out at all. The bacon is nice and crispy. Of course, all the vegetables, fresh and crunchy. Wow. This is a very good burger. I forgot how good this burger is, because it's been over 2 or 3 years since we last came over here. Yeah, there's a reason why Hodad is so popular. Yeah, this is great. This is their famous onion rings. You get quite a few in the basket. Then put some ketchup on it and try this puppy out. Oh yeah. Here we go. I know it's impossible for you to hear that crunch on this onion ring, but it is there. Now, these are great onion rings, nice and crunchy. Oh, look at that. Oh, look at that one. Yeah, these are great.
Look at these fries. Those are like potato wedges. Really nice looking, deeply fried. Crunchy. Pillowy soft on the inside. Now look what I got. I got the tuna sandwich. No shortage of vegetable in here. Got it on sourdough bread. I'm a big fan of tuna. Since you got the burger, I gotta get something else.
No, they gave you a choice of wheat or sourdough.
Correct. So I got the sourdough. Let's see how massive this is. I can even hold it. Okay, there you go. Tons of tuna in there. Big pickles, tomato, lettuce. Oh yeah, it's almost just as big as that burger, baby. Let's go ahead and take a bite. This tuna is delicious. Not heavy on the mayo side. I love all the vegetables in there. Those pickles are nicely crunchy, not too dill. Oh yeah, this is going to be a nice and satisfying tuna sandwich. Just right outside the restaurant in the parking lot is a van, and it's one of their vans. We're going to stick our sticker because you know this place is Bill and Lisa approved.
It is.
Let's see. This is a good empty spot right here.
Okay,
so let's
do
it
right
there. Here. This one here. All right. And, of course, we have our other one, too.
It's upside down, but yeah,
sorry,
we
that
got
one.
It.
Okay, and I'm going to put it probably on the other side. Right here. Right below it.
So there's both of our stickers.
Yep.
If you come over here to Hodad's in Ocean Beach, take a picture with it and tag us.
Yeah.
Tag us on any social media. That was a humongous, delicious burger.
Oh my gosh, it's so much food. It is delicious. It is definitely shareable. Huh, baby?
Yeah, and then some.
Yeah,
this is probably by far the most messiest burger I've had.
But what's nice is it's humongous, yes, but it's very flavorful.
I mean, it is.
It's really a flavor bomb. The meat was tender. It wasn't dry. The bacon was outstanding.
Oh, yeah.
It's
nice and
crispy.
It's a very
good burger. Oh, yeah. Totally.
Oh, yeah. Now, I didn't get to try the tuna sandwich, but you really enjoyed it.
Yeah. It was a very good tuna.
Yeah.
I like the freshness of the tuna and all the vegetables in there. It was delicious. And what's nice is not only the bread, but even the vegetables had like some sort of dressing on it too. So every single one, every single bite was mouthwatering.
Yeah. Now, you know, it's not a cheap place.
It's not. It's
no.
expensive.
Yeah, very much so. But it's definitely worth having it every now and then.
Yes. Yes. So if you're down here, especially if you come there once or twice a year, it could be that type of visit.
Oh, yeah, for sure. Yeah, the place is packed, and this is kind of in between lunch and dinner also.
It is, yeah, and it's a very steady crowd.
Okay, so, you know, we're going to alternate, so now we're going to go for a taco place.
Yes.
Not immediately. We'll give it some time, but tacos are next. We have made it to our taco place.
Yes, it is in Chula Vista. Mm-hmm. It is around maybe 15 minutes from the downtown San Diego, maybe.
Yeah, about 15 minutes north of us is the downtown San Diego.
This is the one that gets highly rated.
Oh yeah, very high. Mm-hmm. But just a few minutes south of here is the Tijuana Mexican border.
Yes, so this one gets the highest rated out of all the Taco El Gordos, and it is also the highest reviewed, like I think 4,000 or 6,000 reviews or something like that.
Yes. Now we know that there's, you know, Tacos El Gordo, a couple of them in Las Vegas.
Yes, we do.
We like those, but here in San Diego, it just, I don't know, it just feels better. It tastes better, right?
Yeah, let's go try it out. And this one's been here forever, so.
It has.
Yeah, let's go try it out. It smells heavenly in here. It is busy. You can see the prices are cheaper than Vegas.
Oh yeah, right here.
Yeah.
The fries. So the operation is the same. You get your food first and then you pay for it.
Yeah. Other than what we know they have, which is the asada, they also have gabeza, buche, suadero, tripas, and lengua. You can get them all in tacos or sopes or anything that you want. So that's something a little different too. Tacos with everything. We got two adobada tacos, which is spicy pork. Adobada vampiro, which is with the crunchy tortilla shells. And some asada fries. This is the small asada fries. This looks really good. It's nice. It's busy. Everything looks fresh.
Yeah.
It's non-stop in here. But what's nice, it's busy, but it's just very steady.
It is.
So it's just non-stop.
Every table is occupied over here. And they do have a few chairs outside as well.
And they have another back section right where the sodas are where you can sit. As well, and those tables are busy too. So let's go dig on in, babe. These are the asada fries. They're very popular. A lot of people are ordering them. You can see the great pieces of asada in here. Fries are done. Let's go ahead and first try out the fry. That's a good tasting fry. It's almost to the point where it's shoestring, but not quite. It's still pillowy in the center, but they taste different.
It kind of looks like the same size of like McDonald's fries.
A little bit thinner, but it has a different taste than McDonald's fries. I can't explain it. I think it maybe the oil that they use is completely different with a little bit of asada. Asada is perfectly done. I can really hit this up with a little bit of lime right here, which the lime and the radishes are all self-serve. Let's go ahead and put that there and on my fry. Oop, get another fry. Get there and put it on my fry. Oh yeah. That is a match with a little bit of lime with these fries. There's just like a sour cream and the cheese right here. There you go. I can see why everyone here, not everyone, but about 90% of the people are getting these asada fries. Delicious.
One of the most popular items at all Tacos El Gordo is the adobada meat taco, otherwise known as pastor. Look at all that guacamole that's on there. They put the, what is it, some parsley? Cilantro?
Cilantro.
Yeah. This looks really good. Sadly, they ran out of pineapple. We asked for some sliced piña, but they ran out. But here we go. There's something uniquely delicious about this adobada taco. It cannot be replicated anywhere. It could only have this certain taste here at Tacos El Gordo. It is fantastic. This is what we always get every time we come here. If you haven't tried this auto bottle yet, we highly recommend it. Yes, it is spicy pork, but not to the point where it's too hot. I think anybody can handle it, even kids. So, highly recommend this one. It's delicious.
We got that vampiro. What the vampiro is two of these really hard, crunchy tortillas. In the middle of it is that adobada. We got the adobada in the middle with the sauce. Look at this. This is cheese right here. That's like on the flat top, and then they stick it on here. Nice little sandwich. You can see here is the top one. Here is the bottom, just gushing out of all this goodness. Let's go ahead. If you haven't tried a vampiro, you gotta try one out. Let's hear this crunch. It's so loud in here, I don't know if you can hear that crunch, but this is some crunchy goodness. You can taste the meat, you can taste that cheese, the sauce, it all blends so well together. And it gives you that crunch factor. Mm. Mm-hmm. This is it.
That was good.
That was delicious. We haven't had tacos al gordo in a while.
Yeah.
It was very good. Just something, it tastes a little bit different here, baby, huh?
It does.
It fires on all cylinders, as you say.
When you're in San Diego, you know, they're real popular for like the Mexican foods, the Cali burritos,
all that
stuff. Yeah. But you know what? That's going to be it for tonight.
It is.
We have two more places tomorrow, so you know we have to spread it out over 2 days.
Yes, we are. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, there's so much food.
Yes.
So we'll see you tomorrow.
Yeah, and we're just watching all these people roll in here.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. I mean, they have a giant parking lot, forgot to mention. Street parking and a big parking lot as well. People move really fast in there.
Oh, yeah.
A lot of people are getting to go's, but it is excellent. I think my new favorite has to be that vampiro.
Yeah.
That's my new favorite. I love the tacos, but you have to get the vampiro.
Yeah. Well, like I mentioned inside, you cannot go wrong with the taco or the vampiro.
Yeah. It's delicious. Yeah.
On this trip, I think we could have did without the fries because they were so filling.
It was.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
It was delicious. I think,
they were very good.
And
yeah.
You know, the fries, I was telling you it tastes different because I think of all of those asada juices were in those fries because mm-hmm. that's what it flavored the fries.
Yes.
So I think that's what it was, baby.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it was good.
It was. Okay, now let's go rest.
Yeah. See you tomorrow.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Now, we stayed overnight here on Shelter Island at Best Western Island Palms.
Mm-hmm.
It's a nice hotel.
It's a nice hotel.
Yeah. Paid only like $139 or so, and that's pretty good for summertime rates.
And I've never heard of Shelter Island before. I didn't know this place even existed. And there's tons of hotels over here. And it is the marina on one side and
the harbor on the other.
The harbor on the other side. It's pretty cool, nice walking area. And we'll give you a little shot of the hotel, the pool. They have things, they have activities going on here every single day.
It's a great family resort. It's only about 15 minutes away from the city center, right?
Mm-hmm.
To downtown San Diego. So yeah, it's a very chill place. Yeah.
So if you don't want to stay in the wildness of the city, this is a good little spot to stay.
Yeah, it's up the street. Great coffee place too. Yeah, so we'll give you a couple shots. Mm-hmm.
We're on the marina side, and this is a long walkway for all of these hotels, and here are all of the boats in the marina. Some of them are pretty fancy pants.
Our first taco spot for today is Ortiz's Taco Shop.
Yeah, is it an only one, baby?
I believe so.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, just a local business here in San Diego, and great reviews.
You gotta try it out.
Great tacos.
In this little mall, too, they have like...
Yeah, a little strip mall.
Bagel place that makes their bagels, and mm-hmm. a donut place, and we're gonna go try out the tacos.
Okay.
I'm ready for tacos.
Yep, me too. Pretty cool vibes in here. One of the first customers here. Now, because we're going to that burger place later, we had to get kind of just the small tacos and those nachos. But looking at the menu, they have menudo, they have some different caldo soups, and tortas, burritos. Mm-hmm.
Those look really good.
And big combination plates. Everything looked really good, you know, so we just have to restrain ourselves and just get focused on the tacos and the nachos today.
Now, this is humongous. Now, this is delicious looking, first of all. It's gonna be hard to finish everything, especially because we have lunch plans, but you know what? We're gonna do our best. This looks amazing. These are pastor and asada tacos.
These are the mini tacos.
These are the mini tacos. Yeah. So these are like street tacos, but hearty looking. And this is the carne asada nachos. Look at that. You can see the meat, the guacamole, sour cream.
And refried beans.
Yep, the beans are in here too. Yeah. Oh, right here. You can see right this one right here.
Mm-hmm.
Refried beans on there. Oh, this looks like a perfect bite right here.
Oh, yeah.
So let's go try this one out.
And it did give you some red and green hot sauce on the side too.
Yes, but we're going to try it without the hot sauce. Let's try this. The carne asada is flavored so well in here, along with the beans, which are really warm, and the toppings that are cold matches this just perfectly. Wow, very good. And then I'm gonna go ahead and try one of these tacos. This one looks like the
pastor
taco right here. Look at that. Oh, these are nice and hot tortilla shells. Oh, got to switch hands. Good size street tacos. The meat is flavored so well in here. These are hot, meaning temperature. Hot, not spicy hot. And you can taste every single layer. You can taste that yumminess of that tortilla, the meat, the guacamole, nice and creamy flavor. Little bit of a crunch from the onion. Oh yeah, this is a well put taco. Very good.
I'm gonna hit these tacos up with a sublime right here. Oh yeah, look at that. That's what you should have did before that first bite, right? These are the two sauces that they gave. They have the green one here, and we tasted the red one, and the red one is a lot hotter than the green one. But let me just go in with this. I love the fact that they put like guacamole in all of the tacos, and put some cilantro and diced onions as well. Here we go. These are great tacos, perfect street size tacos. I love that they give you like two of the tortillas on here. The carne asada is nice and tender, seasoned well. Of course, the onions and the cilantro and the guac really come through on this. These are perfect, maybe three biters, maybe 3 to 4 biters. And also they have, chicken?
Chicken, cabeza, pastor.
And carnitas, and ground beef, I think. But we asked the owner here which is the best ones, and her favorite were the asada and the carnitas. I'm sorry, the asada and the pastor. So those are the two that we got. What a flavor explosion. All the flavors that you see on here, you could taste individually. That's really good. The chips make everything nice and crunchy. Chips, not stale. Of course, when you start mixing all of those components that are on there, boy, that's when it really shines through.
And they're not skimpy on the meat.
They're not
skimpy. Give you a lot of meat.
A lot of refried beans on here, a lot of chips. This is easily shareable for two people, maybe three. All right, Ortiz was pretty good.
Excellent taco shop.
Yeah, now we're going to try to kill like a couple hours because the burger place, our last place, doesn't open until 11 a.m. So let's drive around and see what's here.
Of course, San Diego's a very sightseeing town. So
it is.
We got to go check it out, babe.
Okay. We made it to our final spot for our burger and taco crawl.
And you know what's really cool? It's in here in Chicano Park, and it has a major selection of murals right underneath like a freeway overpass, huh, baby? Everything is all really beautifully painted.
Yeah, well, you kind of jumped the gun.
Oh, sorry.
This area is called Chicano Park.
Okay.
It has like the largest collection of outdoor murals in the whole country. That's what Wikipedia said.
Yeah.
So it's beautiful. They have hand-painted murals all along the streets, on the pillars of where the freeway underpass is.
Yeah.
Even along the walls of the building over here, that's full of murals. So It's pretty cool.
Yeah, it's pretty cool. And just, again, what Jesse was saying, this happened to be our last burger stop, too.
Yes.
So our last burger stop is Hayes Burger.
Yes,
it
Hayes Burger.
It is a local place. We mm-hmm. gotta go try it out.
Yes.
Check this place out. Pretty cool, huh? Yeah. Oh, yeah. There it is. Yeah, very small place right here.
Oh, there's no cash, so it's all credit card only over here. Check out the menu. Oh, in a second, I'll take a look at real quick.
Check out the menu over here.
So these are your burger options. They have grilled cheese, kids burger, and some add-ons over here. So it's a very small menu. They get right to the point. They got burgers.
It only took about maybe a little over 5 minutes to get our burger. There's a few people here already at opening time. This is their most popular double smash cheeseburger. Two patties that are perfectly smashed. We got some nice fresh cut tomatoes, some leaf lettuce in here, two slices of cheese, grilled onions, of course some of that special sauce on here. And this was like a combination because we also got the Jimmy fries, which is their take on like animal style fries from like In-N-Out. Grilled onions, special sauce, melted cheese with some, look like some fresh cut potato fries right here. It just looks delicious, wow. So here we go, double cheeseburger going down. This burger is fantastic. Man, what really stands out is that toastiness. Look at that toastiness on that bun. And the beef, seasoned well, like salt and pepper. That special sauce is almost like a Thousand Island. But the crispiness of the lettuce and the tomatoes, wow. Perfectly well done burger right here. It tastes really good.
Kind of In-N-Out-ish, you think?
It's kind of In-N-Out, but look at the size of those two patties. They're double the size of In-N-Out. So it's almost like you're getting four In-N-Out patties. Almost like a 4x4.
Mm-hmm. Right?
Yeah, but this is excellent. Very good burger.
By looking at this burger, the bun is extremely soft. And what I like, look at this chart on these patties right here. You can really see that like smash size. So I'm expecting these to be just a little bit crunchy. Let's try it out. These patties are delicious. They are kind of just slightly crispy on that side. I like that smash burger option. I like the juiciness of this burger as well. You can see it just glisten. The nice crunchiness of the patty and that freshness of that lettuce. It's a very good burger. We're comparing it to In-N-Out because it has the same components in In-N-Out. This one, I like the patties better because it's more hearty. For me, if I were in this location, this may be my burger of choice other than In-N-Out. If I were in this location. Yeah, this is an excellent burger. Am I saying it's better than In-N-Out? That's what I'm saying for this burger-wise. So this is delicious. They offer two types of ketchups. They have a spicy ketchup and they offer a regular ketchup. I'm gonna go ahead.
This is a
spicy one. Yep. So let's try a little bit here. Let's try this out and see how spicy it actually is. Let's see. First off the bat, the ketchup has a kick to it. If you're not a spice person, eat that one in moderation. You can really taste that spice. It's a good regular like ketchup flavor with a kick. That's a good one. And let me go ahead and finish this fry and I'll try out with all the toppings. First of all, you can see these are thicker cut fries than definitely some other places that do this type of combination. Let's go ahead and get some of the cheese, get that sauce in there. Let's get some onion. Okay, this is a bite and a half. Let's try this out. Fries are very well cooked. It's a little bit on the crunchy side, which is really good, but because of the thicker fries, they're nice and pillowy on the inside. These onions are very well caramelized. They're actually sweet, which is really nice too. And look at that. And it's very saucy and cheesy. If you like saucy and cheesy fries, these are definitely the fries for you.
Oh, well, let me try some of these fries out here. They look really good. Very messy and very delicious looking. Of course, if you don't like any of these toppings, you could subtract any topping or just get regular fries. Mm-hmm. These fries are fried nicely. You have the little bit of that crunchiness, crispiness, edges to the fries. Yeah, the fries make it. These fries are much better than, we don't want to keep comparing to In-N-Out, but I will. These are better than In-N-Out fries. Yeah, this is very good, delicious. Hayes Burger, that was awesome.
That was delicious.
That was the way to end this taco burger tour here in San Diego.
This was a quick day trip only. There's a lot more to do here. We didn't do hardly any sightseeing. This video is very much of an eating video. Sorry for the people who want to sightsee, but next video we promise we'll do a little bit more sightseeing. We didn't do any barbecue down here. We didn't
You know what? In fact, let us know in the comments below if you want to see another San Diego video with some barbecue
pizza.
Pizza,
beer.
California burritos.
Beer crawl, because I mean, down here we're in San Diego. They're known for their beer, right?
In fact, all that might be two more videos.
Yeah, it may be.
Yeah, so let us know in the comments below if you want to see more San Diego.
And we're also thinking maybe do maybe a two night here, because one night we'll hop over to TJ. What do you think, baby?
Yeah, we haven't been to Tijuana in a good 4+ years.
Yes. So maybe that too. Put it in the comments if you want to see that.
Oh, yeah. Okay, well, shout outs.
Yeah, I do. Steve, happy birthday. Stan, Lau, happy birthday. Barry Ever, happy birthday. Teresa Brown, happy birthday. Bruce and Marie, happy 51st anniversary. And Tony and Kathy, happy anniversary.
Happy birthday and happy anniversary, guys. Trisha wondering, do we have any favorites on this whole trip? No, they are all great. We highlighted four great places over here.
Yes, nothing, and we would have told you, nothing really hit below that we were thinking of, because you know, we do our research when we do these videos, and sometimes they don't live up to the standard that we're expecting, because we've been to some of these places before.
Sure.
Everything hit the mark.
Yes.
Everything, yeah. And these new places hit the mark too. The taco place today and the burger place right now.
Cannot go wrong.
Yeah.
All the businesses and addresses are in the video description, so check them out if you're ever in San Diego.
Yes. Oh, and this last one, Hayes Burgers, small place, street parking.
Yes.
A lot of people are getting it to go. There are only like 5 tables outside, just a heads up. Yeah. Because we're in Chicano Park, there's like benches here.
Yeah, that's right.
So you can just take it to go and take it to one of these benches.
Right, where the freeway underpass is, you could have a seat over there.
Yeah, yes.
Yeah. Well, thanks everybody for watching our San Diego little foodie adventure. Until our next one, we'll catch you guys on the next one. That doesn't make sense sometimes when I say
that. We'll catch them on the next one, baby. That's
catch you on the next one.
Catch you on the next one.
Okay.